Hello friends, welcome back to Engineering Today, and we're back with some interesting space updates for you. We'll have a good start with a Starship update, where SpaceX has started the test campaign of Ship 20 with its successful cryo test. Then we'll talk about the recent return of cargo Dragon 23 from the International Space Station, followed by an extension of the time period of public comment for SpaceX's environmental review. Today we'll wrap up with Musk's remarks against Blue Origin's legal actions regarding the HLS. Let's start with a good update of how SpaceX started their orbital Starship test campaign with a successful cryoproof test. SpaceX teams have already started the most awaited test campaign of orbital-class Starship vehicles. They have successfully completed a routine cryoproof test of their first orbital-class Starship prototype, i.e. SN20. On the 27th of September, they started the test campaign of SN20 as a preparatory step for orbital launch. Later on the same day, they also carried out the first cryoproof test of Starship SN20. On the 29th of September, SpaceX teams carried out the cryoproof test for the second time. As per Musk's comment, the test had a good outcome. Musk tweeted, "Proof was good." In the earlier cryoproof tests, none of SpaceX's Starship vehicles had a thermal protection system in full. But this is the first time that SpaceX engineers have made it possible to carry out the cryoproof test with all the 15,000 TPS tiles installed on the vehicle. After the cryo test of Monday, the 27th, it was noticed that some of the heat shield tiles fell off the nose cone area of Ship 20. Michael Baylor of Next Spaceflight had tweeted, "Ship 20 lost some tiles during testing. Those tiles were mostly displaced and flown off from the header tank vent." In a stainless steel vehicle of massive size like Starship, there is continuous expansion and contraction of the metal body with changes in temperature. Keeping up the fragile tiles in place is too challenging work. Musk stated that the trapping of cold gas in a heat pressure thruster had resulted in the displacement of tiles. But if we look into the second cryo test, SpaceX had improved quite well. Reports say that no such shattering and falling of tiles have been noticed during the test. But as the test contains lots of temperature changes, there is a good possibility of having any damage in the heat shield tiles. In the second cryo test, at nearly 8 p.m. Central Daylight Time, SpaceX teams started filling the Ship 20 with liquid nitrogen. Both the tanks meant for methane and liquid oxygen were then gradually filled up with the coolant to simulate the pressure and weight of the operational fuel. Within the next hour, the tanks were nearly half filled. Instead of detanking, they then partially drained the methane or header tank. On the other hand, the liquid oxygen or bottom tank was kept nearly filled with the coolant for the next couple of hours. Several vents from SN20 had started after 4 hours from the start of the test. Normally, detanking procedures take place within this 4-hour time period, but SpaceX's teams had gone further, adding further adventure in the test. While the massive vents were coming from Ship 20 to depressurize the tank, they further loaded tons of liquid nitrogen to further stress the ship. Reports say that SpaceX had started the pressure testing with basically closing the rocket's vents to allow the boil-off nitrogen gas to accumulate and increase pressure up to flight-level pressure or even more. Successful completion of cryo test means that SpaceX had stepped forward for Starship static fire test in the future. Now we'll talk about Cargo Dragon's return to Earth, completing the fifth orbital re-entry of 2021. On the 30th of September 2021, Thursday, the upgraded SpaceX Cargo Dragon had successfully undocked from the International Space Station and flashed down off the coast of Florida. This return of Dragon spacecraft had effectively marked the fifth orbital re-entry of the year. SpaceX had launched the CRS-23 mission towards the space station by late August this year. The Dragon capsule had carried nearly 4,900 pounds of station hardware, experiments, and food cargo to the station. That mission had also nailed the first reuse of Dragon 2's cargo version. This Dragon spacecraft was launched for the first time in December 2020. The undocking procedure of Dragon spacecraft from the space station's Harmony module was monitored by Shane Kimbrough, a NASA astronaut. Under his supervision, the ground controllers from SpaceX headquarters had controlled the undocking procedure and maneuver of thrusters. Kimbrough stated, "I want to give a huge thank you to the SpaceX and the NASA teams for getting this vehicle up to us in great shape, with a lot of science and surprise for the ISS. The activities associated with SpaceX 23 kept our crew busy over the past month. We look forward to hearing about the results of the payloads we interacted with. Have a safe journey back to Earth." At nearly 9:12 a.m. Eastern Daylight Time, the Dragon capsule gets undocked from the station's Harmony module. After undocking, the capsule fired its thrusters a number of times and finally splashed down near the Florida coast at 10:59 p.m. Eastern Daylight Time. SpaceX tweeted, "Splashdown of Dragon confirmed, completing SpaceX's 23rd cargo resupply mission to the space station. Dragon 23 returned to Earth with nearly 2,900 kilograms of biomedical experiments, microgravity experiments, and other cargo. As for the rest of 2021, SpaceX's Crew Dragon is scheduled to send another group of four astronauts, Crew 3, to the space station by the end of October this year. There will be astronauts both from NASA and the European Space Agency for the Crew 3 mission. Sixth orbital re-entry of the Dragon capsule will commence with the return of four Crew 2 astronauts to Earth. SpaceX has also planned to launch their next Cargo Dragon mission by the beginning of December this year. Our following update is based on the time extension of public comment for environmental review. On Thursday, the Federal Aviation Administration announced about extending the time for public comment period for SpaceX's draft of environmental review. The Super Heavy program in Boca Chica now has the public comment period extended up to November 1st. SpaceX cannot launch the Starship Super Heavy vehicle without the completion of the agency's license process. This licensing process also includes the environmental review. In September, the administration released their environmental view draft, consisting of 151 pages. This review is concerned with issues like SpaceX's mission's impacts, Boca Chica's road closures, and debris recovery. Now, after all the reviews, if the organization finds that the effects of the upcoming project is going to be significant and these effects cannot be diminished, then there might be another more intense review. SpaceX, however, hasn't made any immediate response to this commenting scheme. According to sources, SpaceX was warned by the Federal Aviation Administration, or FAA, around July that the company might need to remove one of the two new towers due to the delay in the environmental review. The FAA also mentioned that SpaceX's under-construction building, the Integration Tower, is being built at the company's own risk. On May 6th, SpaceX received a letter from the agency saying that the construction of one tower might induce complications in the environmental review process. Also, there's a chance that changes will be required at the launch site, along with the integration towers, in order to reduce significant effects. Now our final update is about Elon Musk's remarks in an interview against Blue Origin's lawsuit. The conflict between SpaceX and Blue Origin is still unresolved. Elon Musk is against Jeff Bezos' legal actions related to the human landing systems. After the failure of the initial objections, the case will still be evaluated until the end of October. NASA and SpaceX are unable to continue the project before any decision is made. Upon being asked about the scenario at Vox Media's annual code conference on the 28th of September, Musk replied, "You cannot sue your way to the moon, okay? No matter how good your lawyers are. I think he should put more of his energy into getting to orbit than lawsuits." The response referred to a suborbital flight taken in July, where Bezos faced some technical issues with their new Shepard. Aside from their only current operational vehicle, the company is working on another launch system and a lunar lander. SpaceX, on the other hand, is working with its Falcon 9 rocket and Dragon capsule. It's also testing prototypes based on its proposal for NASA's moon landing demands. NASA has been allotted a much lower amount for the HLS program. Other programs of the organization are also facing delay. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe for more videos like this. Hit the like button if you find the video interesting, and kindly provide your valuable feedback in the comment section. This will help us to improve.